All questions?
Akshay.
One and two.
You thought that you can come to the Dhamma during the meditation, but what about before the meditation, after the meditation? Will this stay with you? Your clear mind? You first really live during the meditation, you live before and after. So, what do we need is that what you get during the meditation, let's say clear mind, this feeling will stay with you for a long time.
In Hebrew, please.
Wow, in Russian,
Before meditation, there's no use to ask the question. After meditation, you already understand. So, before you started to practice, your own thing, your own noise controlled you. And it's usually our personal suffering, something really personal motivation why we start to practice. You practice hard, it stays with you for a long time. You practice a little, it disappears next day. As we say in our temple rules, shouting into a valley. Small shout, small echo, big shout, big echo.
Okay. What do you say? Constantly
So, first, we have what we call formal meditation. That's what people are afraid of, but it's not necessary to be afraid of formal meditation. It seems a little strange at first. Usually the first question is, what's going to happen to me if I sit down like this? Will I change? Well, you change anyway, sweetheart, you just don't know it. So, whether you are aware of that change or not, you change anyway. But if you perceive this change, you can actually give a direction to it. So when you fly and it's no longer Kansas, you really have to set your compass clear to land where you want to land. Then you have to set the compass, your navigation, so that you land in the right place. In other words, with meditation you can really find your life direction. Like I said with an earlier reply, this is a direction that you have to find yourself. We are capable of it. And some people would say that their opinion is better than your own experience, so they would want to take away that experience or prevent you from having it.
יש אנשים שיגידו שהדעה שלהם יותר נכונה מהחוויה שלך, אז הם ינסו לקחת את החוויה ממך.
And the second part comes when this formal meditation becomes so frequent that your mind is actually constantly staying clear, like a mirror.
שלב השני, התרגול הפורמלי הוא כל כך תדיר, חזק, אז שהרגעים אחרי זה נשארים גם בהירים.
You know, it's like reaching orbit. Of course you don't know. That's why I'm telling you. So, it's like when the rocket reaches orbit. You know, when you're on orbit, then you don't fall back on Earth anytime soon. You still would. You need energy to stay on orbit. The biggest energy, the biggest booster, you need to get free from Earth's gravity.
Like a כוח המשיכה של כדור הארץ, והוא נכנס למסלול סביב כדור הארץ. אתה צריך הרבה מאוד כוח, וצריך גם אחרי זה לתרגל, לשמור על הסיבור הזה, בהתחלה זה אחרי אותו.
So, if you practice, then you realize something else, something more important than your own individual question.
אם אתה מתרגל, אתה מבין משהו יותר חשוב מהשאלה האישית שלך.
You realize that you may solve your own problem and you could be constantly meditating and be in nirvana, but
אתה מבין שיכול להיות שאתה מתרגל ומגיע למצב של נירוונה תמידי, אבל
but then other people come into your room and they ruin it completely.
אבל אז אנשים נכנסים לחדר ועושים לך את כל זה.
So then what do you do?
אז מה אתה עושה?
You just really tell them off and shout at them, do not ruin my peaceful meditation. Do you understand?
האם אתה צועק עליהם ואומר להם, אל תרסו לי את המדיטציה השקטה שלי?
So, you see the paradox here.
אתה מבין את הפרדוקס?
So you will see in your practice that when you finish your problem, other people will come naturally to you with theirs and you will be helping them.
אתה רואה שבתרגול שלך, ברגע שאתה מסיים עם הבעיה שלך, אנשים אחרים יבואו עם בעיות משלהם ואתה תוכל לעזור להם.
You don't help them because you are so altruistic and morally so elevated. That's not the reason. The reason is much more practical.
אתה לא עוזר להם משום שאתה נעלה מבחינה מוסרית. הסיבה היא מאוד פרקטית.
The practical reason is that if you don't help them, then their problem will strike you.
סיבה מעשית, אם אתה לא תעזור להם, הבעיה שלהם תוכה בך.
And then you see that helping them is the same as helping yourself.
ואז אתה רואה שלעזור להם זה כמו לעזור לעצמך.
That's the second part of meditation which has no form, no observable time between 1 and 30 minutes or 40 or 50, but the mind is constantly staying clear, 100% connected with the universe, trying to save other people from suffering.
זאת הנקודה השנייה של מדיטציה שמחוץ לתרגול פורמלי של 30 דקות, אלא להתחבר לקוסמוס and helping
them. And actually helping other
people. לעזור לכם.
So the first, the formal part has a beginning and an end, fortunately. Every retreat has a beginning and end.
לצד הפורמלי של מדיטציה יש התחלה וסוף, לכל ריטריט יש התחלה וסוף למרבה המזל.
But the second doesn't have it.
השני אין התחלה.
The second has no beginning and no end.
הנקודה השנייה אין התחלה.
And once you wake up to that, we wake up to our original human job.
ברגע שאתה מתעורר לזה, אתה מתעורר לעבודה המקורית של בני האדם.
And when somebody has got that level, then only Sivu Haroshiva, all the best.
ברגע שמישהו מגיע לרמה הזו?
All the best. פרוסקי.
כל טוב. ברגע שאתה מגיע לנקודה הזאת, אז אתה אומר לי, כל טוב.
Your question.